His Excellency, Admiral General Aladeen of the North African nation of Wadia, held a press conference Monday at New York's Waldorf Astoria Hotel. Here now is an ABN exclusive report with highlights from the General's remarks.
Jahnoon, welcome, devils of the Zionist media, and death to the West. Today, I wish to highlight the plight of a terribly endangered group, the innocent victims of a global human tragedy, dictators. These brave leaders are suffering a daily victimization and brutality for the supposed crime of embezzling money and doing a tiny little bit of genocide. Now please, let's take some questions. Anyone from the North Korean press? I'm kidding, they don't have one.
Can I ask a question, Supreme Leader?
Okay, go.
What would you have to say to your critics out there who label you a tyrant?
I would say thank you. Also, could you please give me the names and addresses of the so-called critics and their routes to and from work? I'd like to give them a magnetic gift. It attaches to the underneath of the car. Okay, next.
How do you plan to ensure that democracy will never, ever take over your country? And why do you feel that you will succeed when so many other dictators have failed?
Well, my people, they don't want democracy. They love me, and I have many signed confessions to that effect. I am like a father to my people, quite literally to about 1,800 of them. Besides, our version of government is much more efficient than yours. Democracy is the worst. Endless talking and everyone's vote counts, no matter how black or crippled or female you are.
What are your favorite things to do in New York City?
As far as the tourist sites, I love to see the Empire State Building and the Statue of Liberty, and also the hotel curtain where Dominic Strauss-Kahn wiped his bilbul after doing a sex activity with that chambermaid.
Who are your favorite of your fellow dictators, and why, please?
Well, it has been a tough year. We have lost a lot of good people, and I have lost a lot of good friends. Gaddafi, I miss you. Gaddafi, I miss you. Kim Jong. And of course, Chavez died last month. You did not hear that from me. Okay, Chavez is fine. It's just a coincidence that he hasn't turned up for about 2 months.
Nimrod Vir, Israel.
What?
My name is Nimrod Vir.
You are a Jew?
I'm a Jew and I'm from Israel.
You are a Jew?
Very Jewish, yeah.
Very Jewish?
Very Jewish.
Prove it.
Come.
Let me have a look. Come. Let me have a look. Come on. Okay. You don't need to be shy. There's nobody watching. What have you got down there? It's not, believe me, it's not big. If it was big, you would have got it out already. What have you got down there? No?
No,
you're shy? Come on, I just have a little look. It's mainly hair. All I can see is hair. Okay. What do you want?
Well, my question is sort of related. We have elections in 4 months in Israel, and would you consider running for president in Israel?
Would I consider? Yes, yeah. The first thing I would do would be to destroy Israel. Okay, all right, thank you, death to the West. Please enjoy yourselves, and you may enjoy the prostitutes we brought in, or the boys, if you like, if you're from Canada. Enjoy. And as long as you write good reviews, your families will be released. Enjoy, and hafla. Death to the West. Thank you.
And there you have it, the latest from the world's most beloved dictator. This has been an ABN exclusive report.